I'm Anuj Prasad and I'm the co-founder of Desmania Design. It is an industrial design firm based out of NCR. This company was formed almost like 25 years back, and in last 10 years we've also developed a facility for automotive design, which is one of its kind in the country. When the automobiles were made, way back when they started mass producing in 1920s, it was a commodity, you know. So there was no design. There was only one color, one shape, one size. The whole idea was to only manufacture as many as possible. The way it has evolved now is more emotional in nature. So that emotive aspect in automobile is very, very high. And it is comparable actually to your personal products, like the shirt which you wear, the watch which you wear, the shoes, the bag which you carry. These are your personal products and they manifest your personality. Meeting the user, talking to them, understanding, observing as to what's happening, checking out on technology is a very big aspect of design. So once you gain these consumer insights, you draw out a certain criteria and a design brief. This design brief is the basis of design. So that's a starting point. So after which there's an exploration, which is to do with the exterior and the interior of any vehicle. So many, many multiple sketches are made, like hundreds and hundreds of sketches. It is not a field where you can just do with five designs and work on it. So once the concept is shortlisted, then you very quickly convert this into a 3D format in the computer. And this 3D format is something where you can work on further refinement of exterior, interior, looking at the ergonomics part and all, and then do something called clay modeling. So this clay modeling is not a regular clay. It's a very high-end, expensive clay which is made only by three companies in India, in Japan, Germany and the US. So this clay is actually put on a certain armature and you make a 1:1 clay buck. And then through data, you can mill the rough surface. So same thing goes for the interiors of a car also. So you do something which is called an ergonomic buck, where you check the leg room, the head space, you know, and the comfort of sitting, how much can you go behind, the comfort of sitting in different rows of seating and all. So there's a whole lot of importance and emphasis which is given to the clay model, because car is something where the investments are like in millions and millions of dollars, hundreds of millions. And the stakes are so high that you can't take a risk of giving out something which is, you know, half-baked. So clay gives you a possibility of doing refinements multiple times. So this is the whole process of creativity. So once this creative process is done, which takes at least 6 to 8 months time, thereafter the whole thing is handed over to the technical team. And then technical team takes care of converting this whole design into components, you know, allocating materials, process, and at many places designers are actually supporting this. So I think one is the side view of the car, which gives you a certain stance, and second is the fascia, the way it looks, the expression which it gives you. So a combination of these two, which is called a 3/4 perspective, you know. So when designers conceptualize, they conceptualize on these two sides. Each country has a very specific kind of a design language. Europe is the one which has evolved the most in terms of design language, and they believe a lot in extending the brand across their entire portfolio. So you can see that most of the big brands in Europe could be identified just by the look from a distance. When we look at the US, I think they are more functional, and that's the way they design everything. Now in last 10-15 years, with design becoming more important for them, there's a certain emotional aspect. Otherwise, they're more utility-driven kind of cars, little more boxy, larger in size. And you'll see this characteristic happening in all the cars being manufactured in the US. Whereas Japan, the design philosophy is very different, you know. It is very manufacturing-oriented design, and it is also very reliability-oriented. So what they do is they don't design outside in, but they largely design inside out. So their cars are absolutely great in performance. And You know, they are extremely reliable, but they don't look great. Many cars, if you see, are very close to the sketch and they do absolutely look awesome, you know. So the car which I feel looks closest to the sketch is Land Rover's Evoque, you know. It looks like a sketch. It is as if somebody had sketched it and converted this into a functional 3D model, you know.